Okay, so let's look at elliptic curve cryptography and how we get the points on a curve to be able to perform our operations. So an elliptic curve, or one type of elliptic curve, is defined by this equation here. Okay, so the parameters that we have on an elliptic curve are A, B, and then if we plot the elliptic curve in its continuous form, we pick a point on the elliptic curve called G, which is the generator point. It's an XY point, G. That's the base of the point of the curve. Then we pick P, the prime number, and finally we have what's called N, which is the order, and that's the total number of points that we can have on our elliptic curve from this form here. So altogether, these give us our elliptic curve parameters for this. So let's see if we can find the points on the elliptic curve. So let's take a prime number of 11 and work out where our points are. And we'll take a typical curve, or a fairly typical curve, of 7 for B, 0 for A, and we'll take 11 for our prime number. Okay, so remember the mod operation is the remainder after division by 11. So if we try x equal to 1, then we get y squared is equal to 1 plus 7 mod 11. So that's 8 mod 11, which gives 8 mod 11. And there is no value of y which gives us 8. If we went through all the values of y, we can't find a square root, or what's called a modular square root, of 8 to give us this. So there is no point at x equals 1. If we now try x equals 2, so y squared is equal to 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8 plus 7 mod 11. So that gives us 15 mod 11, which gives us 4, and that's quite easy because that's 2. 2 squared is equal to 4. So we've found the what's called the quadratic residue of this. So we have a point at 2, 2. We also have another point on the elliptic curve because there is another value for y squared equal to 4 mod 11. And that value what we want is a value when we square it and we take mod 11, it's going to give us 4. And I just so happen to know that that value is 9. So if we take 9 squared and then we do a mod 11, then we will get 77 and we'll get a result of 4. So you can see here that the other value that we'll have is 2, 9. We can continue on. So if we take an x value of 3, then y squared is equal to 1 cubed plus 1 x equal 3 is 3 cubed plus 7 mod 11. And we've got 3 to the cubed plus 7 is 34 mod 11. So we can see that that equals 1. And y squared equal to 1, the result of that is 1. There is also another value, if we were to do it, at 10. So we have two values here, 3, 1, and 3, 10. In this way, you can see that we end up with points in the elliptic curve. I'll just complete them all. So 2, 9, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3, 10, 4, 4, 4, 7, 5, 0, 6, 5, 6, 6, 7, 3, 7, 9. Okay, so we can see whenever we have an x value, it will either give us 9 or 2. An x value of 2 will give us 9 or 2. An x value equal to 3 will give us the result of 1 and 10. Okay, so there are some points that don't exist on this curve, but these are the ones that do exist. So we can see that the values that we've got going in will always give us a different value out. So this gives us a 9, a 1, a 4, a 0, a 5, 6, and a 3. So we have a mapping from the x to the y, where we will always get a unique point out for the curve. Okay, so in this way, we actually end up with our points on the curve in a discrete way. The way we use this typically is that we take our base point. So if we just draw our elliptic curve, then it might look a bit like this. So the two main operations that we have with an elliptic curve is the point add and the point doubled. A point add is that we take one point and we add another point. So point 1 plus point 2. And the other operation that we have is to double the point. And the thing with an elliptic curve is that whenever we add one point to another, we always get another point on the elliptic curve. So the point add is this operation and the double point. So how we use this in elliptic curve cryptography is that we come up with a private key. And the private key is a random value. And the value is somewhere between 0 and n, where n is the order of the curve. We then work out a public key point by adding g. The number of times in our private key. So if the private key was 10, then we will add g 10 times. And we represent that as that. So that's 10g, where p, the private key, is the value of 10. This becomes our public key, and this becomes our private key. And the thing with elliptic curve is that it's very difficult to determine, if this is a large number, the value that was created to be able to create that value. If we use a 256-bit random number, then there are just too many points that are possible to be able to determine what that value actually is. And the operation here is made even easier if we use what's called Montgomery's method. And Montgomery's method will take the value of n And then within a few steps, actually equal to the number of bits that is represented by the prime number and the doubling and the adding, we can very quickly multiply up our point using the point addition and point doubling. In this way, we can create what's called a fixed time in creating the value of ng, which is our public key. And no one, even who's listening to the communication, can determine the value of n, because we always use the same number of steps at each time. Okay, so this gives you a quick overview of elliptic curve cryptography and how it's actually used. If we recap, we have the parameters for the curve, and every curve shares these parameters, and it's a well-known curve. So typical curves are this one for Bitcoin, or we can use curve 25519. The interesting thing with curve 25519 is that the prime number is equal to 2 to the power of 255 minus 19. So then that curve gives us our layout. We then pick a generator point on the curve, and then we will add that point a given number of times, typically with our private key value, to create our public key. And it's this public key which can be shared, and it's not possible to determine what the private key value is.